So, to my mind, science provides the most amazing creation story of all, and one that has the distinct likelihood of being true. Okay, let's have a short 3-minute video, and then there's another short, even shorter video after that. Let's take a look. So theories about the Big Bang and evolution provide good answers to questions about how we got here. But they're less helpful with questions about what we're supposed to do and how we're supposed to live as we fly through this rock, fly through space on this rock. And religions, at their best, help us understand our place in creation. So Matthew Fox, who I mentioned here before, they actually attend, he's a former Catholic priest who created something called the University of Creation Spirituality, now called Wisdom University, and he says the following in his book, One Great Rabbinic Wells. Religions provide us with a perspective, a lens through which we see creation and interpret it. Religions are integral to creation because they themselves are created, set up by humans in relationship to their stories of the divine. If humanity is to draw wisdom from all its wisdom traditions, then our relation to creation will form the basis for that interchange. The reason is that we all have creation in common. Creation is bigger than all of us, bigger than our religions, and far more ancient. So what are we then to do about this creation we all have in common? One answer is to enjoy it. One spiritual practice that I'm able to do consistently is walk from my car through the parking lot to the building I work in without looking at my phone. There was a time where I would catch myself, you know, walking in, looking at my phone, and I realized I was missing, you know, the beautiful blue sky and the birds and the flowers. I was missing out on creation. And so now when I walk my building, I use that time to observe and be thankful for the natural world. Unless, as I'm walking in, I see something, maybe then I know on the way into the building. And we've said we humans are wonders of creation also, right? So I might wait a minute for that person, if they're just coming in or trying to catch up with somebody. I might even talk to somebody I don't know. I don't want to be so focused on the natural world that I lose touch with the human creations around me. Another answer is to care for creation, the natural world and one another. Regarding the natural world could, of course, mean things like using environmentally safe products and recycling, etc. It could mean banding together with others to support efforts such as clean air and water, renewable energy, to build a land we want, as the song says. Caring for one another also may mean supporting causes that improve people's lives, as well as participating in random acts of kindness for family or friends, strangers that we may meet. Recently, I was happy to be able to go for a jog. I haven't been able to do that for a while, so I pulled my Achilles tendon, and so I've been sort of missing out on it. I live in Pantop, so I just had a short jog down to the Ravana River, and there's a nice path that goes along both sides. And I often stop about halfway through that jog and meditate, which feels really good to connect with nature. And as I'm jogging, there's usually other people coming towards me. I smile, acknowledge them, and they often smile back. Connecting with other people makes me feel really good. I happened to see three ladies who were trying to jog. They were having some difficulty. They stopped to walk. They jogged again. And then when I passed them, they had stopped again, tired. And I said, "Good work, ladies," as a way to encourage them, because they obviously were trying really hard. Small gestures of caring can go a long way. And I venture each one of you has spiritual practices that you use to get in touch with the natural world and with one another. I've shared a few with mine. Maybe in the social hall you can talk about some of the ways that you connect with nature and with other people. Certainly these celebrations are intended to be a way to connect with others, and hopefully connect with that creative spirit that resides within each one of us. And of course, the UU principles that we sang about in our opening song can be a guide for us as we enjoy and care for creation. I'll end with a quote from the book, the brothers Karamazov by Russian author Fyodor Dostoevsky. Matthew Fox quotes him in this book. Love all creation, the whole and every grain of sand in it. Love every leaf, every ray of light. Love the plants, love the animals, love everything. If you love everything, you will perceive the divine mystery in all things. Once you perceive it, you will comprehend it better every day. And you will come at last to love the whole world with an all-embracing love. May it be so. Blessed be.